Hi everybody, how are you doing? In this video, I am sharing my grocery haul, my monthly grocery trip. Not the haul, but a grocery trip. I don't know if you have gone grocery shopping yet, but I was really nervous to do it in this time period because I was hearing all these crazy things about having to wait in line before you go in the store, about things being out at the store, and just different things, and I didn't know what to expect, and I don't like not knowing what to expect. I hope this video can help somebody. I know it's different everywhere, but maybe this will give you a better idea of what to expect when you go grocery shopping. Stay till after the video if you want to hear some chatty time with me, and we'll just kind of update you. If you're brand new here, please do consider subscribing. I try to post relevant resources every Thursday. I'm here at Costco, and they appear to be open. I thought Costco opened at 10, but people are shopping right now. So here I am. Guys, I've been really nervous about this trip. I don't know what to expect. So maybe you're in the same boat and I'm taking you along with me. Let's go shop. No. Looks like they're allowing seniors to shop Tuesdays and Thursdays, 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. They're yelling at us to stay in one line. I usually start Costco this way, opposite, but we'll go ahead and go this way. This is the line for paper and water.
The line is actually even longer.
After standing in that huge line, the line has gone down to like nothing. So I think I just arrived with the rush of people, which is cool. They'll send in the next wave of people soon. But we're just gonna do our shopping. It's all about mindset, so I'm gonna get my game face on and I will talk to you guys soon. We're down to the last few things on our list. I noticed that Costco does not have baby food, and for a split second I had this feeling of panic. But that's ridiculous because baby food's super easy to make, and also they were out of mayonnaise, which is also super easy to make, so that it's no worries, no worry. The cart is so heavy, guys. It's like having to confront the weight of the consumerism of your family. And I don't mean that in a negative way, but like what your family consumes, and really take accountability for that. And it's so heavy. I'm almost done.
That's the line, y'all.
So now we wait. It's unusually quiet. How many people are in here? Okay, so we're done, and I spent so much money. I bought our entire month's worth of groceries just about today, and it's not even April yet, and these are my April groceries. But guys, I don't want to go back. I don't want to go back to the store, so I just got it, and now it's going to be a matter of planning the food so that this lasts us. We got some potting soil because we are making our garden. Where are my keys? Let me tell you, I've never had this level of service at Costco. They put all the stuff on the grocery belt for me, the shopping belt. They are gonna load my car for me. I'm gonna go drive up. It's amazing. Oh man, I love it. There's this girl in there, she's making a joke. She's like, I work hard for my money. And she's singing and dancing, and it's ridiculous. It's so ridiculous. So, all right, we're off. Man, it is gorgeous outside. This has really made it nice to stay in place and stay grounded and take lots of walks. Where we're at, we're on shelter in place right now. And so basically that means the only time we can go out is for essential reasons, grocery stores, essential work. The day that I went shopping, I had a lot of anxiety, and I don't know if you can tell in that footage there, but I literally was having a panic attack the whole time because I had this idea of how it might be in my mind shopping. And then when I got there, it was just as bad as I had imagined. And so I was just so anxious. But that being said, it's all about mindset. I really believe that. And so I'm trying to stay really positive, and I want to bring that to this channel. I don't want to put fear out there. Mm-mm. I don't believe in that, because God is on our side and there's nothing to fear. You know, at the end of the day, God wins. I don't want to put fear out there, but it is a real emotion that I am feeling and was feeling. But I'm not the type that's like, oh, it's an emotion that I'm feeling, therefore I must share it all and explore all the details of it. I'm not saying that you need to oppress your emotions, but I don't really buy that. God told us not to fear, you know? So let's not fear. I heard on this podcast, Corona is a little C and Christ is a big C. So let's focus on that big C, Christ, and just enjoy the fruit of being home with our families. I'm just loving getting to spend our outside time and doing projects and just pressing into the home stuff. I really, really appreciate that. And you know, there may be some uncertain things, but I really believe that, you know, God will fill the flour sack if he needs to, and it's gonna be okay. So know that I am there with you and praying for you. If you have any special intentions, feel free to put them in the comments below or email me at wholecatholicliving@gmail.com. And anyway, take care of yourselves. Take care. Bye.